Good morning, team. I'm so sorry I'm 5 minutes late. Are we back? Is anybody there? Let me know if you're there. I'm having major internet meltdowns at the moment. I don't know what's happening. It's taken me that long to try and connect. I actually had to shut down my phone and start again. So I apologize. We've got a couple on board, so we are live. That's awesome. Okay, so this morning we've got a bit of a circuit. We are going to do a beat the clock round again, but we're using a big kitchen pot. So if you haven't grabbed one out already, go grab one. This is the biggest one I actually have. Now we want it to be nice and stable on the ground so that the handles aren't rocking around or anything. And a little bit of weight to it is good. Mine's not overly heavy, but we'll be able to get through the workout anyway. So if you're there, let me know, just so I know that it's all working. I will keep an eye on it, and hopefully we don't get interrupted halfway through the feed. But yeah, so we've got a few drills to get through today, a few little fun things, and then we've got a little bit of a challenge song at the end, because I do always love my challenge songs. So we're just breaking it up, mixing up the training a little bit, doing something a little bit different. And working with a few moves and directions that we don't work with in the other classes. So this one's always a little bit random. It's when I get to get a little bit creative because I do miss all of that. So it's all about utilizing the things that we've got at home today. So a kitchen pot's a great place to start. There's heaps of things that you can do with it. And I'll run you through some of them. So if you've got a big kitchen pot, grab one now, hit like when you've got one. Otherwise you can use a big wok. Basically anything that's got just a little bit of height and will sit flat on the ground as well. All right, so we'll get into it and start warming up. Just turn the music up. All right, so let's start by twisting. How's everybody feeling today? I think my butt's really sore, in all honesty, after all this training the last 2 days. All right, let's reach with those arms. So really lifting that heel, rotating and pivoting on the toes. This helps to warm up the ankles. Let's walk it up. Bring it back down. All right, let's take the arms out to the sides and twist. So just starting nice and small if your legs are a little stiff. Taking it down a little lower as we warm up. Let's make it a little bigger. See if you can reach a little lower. Squat and reach, chest to center. Reach it up. Double tap the floor. That's it. Couple more. Keep that gaze forward so that we're squatting into the knees. Can you go a little lower? One more. All right, arm circles. Let's warm up those shoulders. Take it back the other way. All right, let's twist it out. So making sure that back's nice and warm. And feet out the back. Gonna get a little bit of length in those quads. Take the knees out the front. Keep the core nice and tight as you lift the knees. Let's get nice and high, warming up those hips. All right, we're gonna add elbow to knee. So twisting through the torso. All Alright, let's take one foot out the back. Now if you have trouble balancing, one finger up. And we want to try and keep the knees aligned. So if you look side on, aligned and not forward. So if you need to loosen that off a little, do it. If you want to increase the stretch, push the hip forward. So take that foot out the front, ankle circles. Other side, one foot out the back. Push the hip forward. And ankle circles. Back the other way. All right, we're just gonna bounce on the spot a little, get nice and warm. We're gonna start with a trap timer, which is very similar to a Tabata timer. So we're gonna be working with 8 seconds of work and 12 seconds of rest, okay? So it's a short little burst. It's gonna lift our cardiovascular system. Just make sure that we're nice and huffy puffy for the rest of the session. So when you're ready, if you need to take a layer off, take a layer off. I'm just gonna grab a quick drink because I always get so dry and thirsty with all this talking.
Okay. So grabbing your kitchen mat.
Placing it in the center. Want a nice stable surface. So for our 8 seconds work, we're gonna toe tap. Now all the body weight is on that grounded foot on the floor, okay? Not on the pot. So we're just tapping really lightly with the feet. Then we're just gonna tap it out nice and slow, okay? So 8 seconds of fast toe taps, 12 seconds of slow. This is gonna build it up, okay? Alrighty. So let's start by tapping it out. Go. Alright, tap it out. 8 seconds of work coming up in 4, 2, 1. Let's speed it up. 8 seconds. As fast as you can go. 2, 1, tap it out. Going again in 5, 2, 1, let's go. So keep the core tight, keep the body upright, just a light tap on top. Tap it out, all right, let's crank it up. 3, 2, 1, let's go. So we're lifting it up now. You'll be starting to feel quite warm. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Tap it out. This has got to be the world's greatest workout song, doesn't it? 2, 1, go. Can you speed it up? Tap it out. That's it. So remember, all the weight's on the floor, body weight's on the floor. We're not stepping on the pot, we're just tapping. Go! Can we speed it up? We've only got a couple of rounds left, so let's make the most of it. Three, two, go. That's it. Five, three, two, one, last one. Let's speed it up. And rest. Well done. Woo. All right, so we're just going to breathe it out a little. Step it out. Let me know how you went with that. If you've got a photo of your pot, maybe you can throw it up there. Hi. All right. So next we've got our beat the clock round. If you didn't go fitter last week, you'll know all about the beat the clock. So basically we're going to increase, I've mixed it up a little bit. We are going to be using our pods. We're going to start with the 30 second round, 30 second break. Then it's going to go to a minute round, 30 second break. So 30 seconds break every time, but the round is going to increase by 30 seconds every round, okay? Now we're also going to add another little variation in there, okay? So I'll just bring my board in. Now you guys are going to be impressed. I've done incredible backwards riding again. So I'm going to put this right, I'll put it on this side, right here on the edge of the screen. Is anybody there left-handed by any chance? If you are, let me know, because I feel for you guys, it's really hard. I had to write from left side to right side and everything was backward, and I just, yeah, I commend you guys. What an incredible skill to have. Okay, so if you can read that slightly, it's basically meant to just be cues, okay? So I will still say the exercises out loud. But just in case you get ahead of me, hopefully you can work out, reading it upside down and back to front's really hard, but hopefully you can get a bit of a cue of what's coming up next. So we're going to start with 6 reps. Then in the next 30 second round of 6 reps, 1 minute round of 6 reps each. Then we're going to go to 1.5 minutes at 8 reps. So we're going to increase by 2 reps every one solid 1 minute block, okay? So I'll talk you through that as we go through. And then once we get to 12 reps, we're going to stay on 12 reps of each until we make it all the way down to the bottom, okay? Once you make it all the way past burpee, I should have written plank on there, drop down into a plank or hit like once you've finished your burpee. So I know everyone's completed the round and that'll be the end of the game. Okay, so to start with, we've got a squat press at the top of the list. So we're jumping it to the ground, taking it up overhead. Just like that, okay? So that's a squat press. Then we're gonna do a front squat pulse. So in squat position, we're gonna take the pot out to the front. You can't see me, can you? All right, pot out to the front, and we're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 8, or 10, or 12, or whatever reps we're on. So that's a pulse at the bottom. And around the world is from the inside of the foot up and over to the inside of the other foot. So if you think about like those little ribbons from, let's say breast cancer research, the pink ribbon that you wear, how they go like that, that's basically your flight path for your pot. So opposite side to the inside of the other opposite side. So we're crossing over the body. Then we've got bicep curls with our pot. Hopefully you've got a nice heavy one. Then we're going to move into overhead triceps. So overhead triceps are these ones. Okay, then we're going to move into, we're going to place it on the ground. This is where you need your sturdy pot. We're going to put the front foot on, drop it back into a lunge, bring it up, high knee. Okay, so anything that's got two sides, it's going to be 10, let's say 10 total reps. So that'd be 5 on each side, like so. So that's your reverse lunge, your lunge with high knee. Then we're going to move into an uneven push-up. So we're gonna have one hand on, one hand off, then walk the hands over. Like so, okay? Again, 10 in total, so 5 each side. Then we've got, this chair's gonna be a problem, isn't it? Then we've got a bridge march. So if you can see there, it's hard to tell with the comments. We're gonna place both the feet on, lifting up into a bridge. We're gonna extend one leg. That's one, two, three, four, etc. All the way to 10 or 12. Then we have a Russian twist, which is side to side, like so. You can have the feet on the ground or elevated. Then we're gonna finish with a burpee. So with the burpee, you're gonna take your hands to the pot, jump it back, jump it in, take the pot up, one, two, like so. My pot's not exceptionally heavy or anything. It's more about just getting the moves done, creating that little bit of an uneven surface to work with as well, which is gonna make it a little bit more challenging. Just add that little bit of height to the body weight stuff. Okay, so we're starting with six reps and 30 seconds. I'll just get back to the right timer. And we're going until we've completed the whole list and made it to plank before the timer goes off, okay? So 10 seconds, we're starting with the squat press, six of them. Three, two, one, squat press. One, two, three, four, five, six. Take it out the front and pulse. One, two, three, four, five, six. What's next? We've got around the world. Inside of the foot. One, three, four, five, six. Bicep curls. One, two, three, four, five, six. We're starting with 1 minute straight up. I didn't realize. One, two, three, four, five, six. Lunge high knee to the floor. Step it on. Take it down. One, two, three, four, five. Shake it off. Alrighty, so we're going for a minute and a half. Next up, you can step it side to side in your rest break. You can go back to toe taps if you like. If you want to make it that little bit harder. Going again in 10 seconds. From the top. Squat press, six, five, four, three, two, one. Front squat pulse. One, three, four, five, six. Let's take it around the world. Five, six. Bicep curl. Three, four, five, six. Overhead tricep. Three, four, five, six. Lunge high knee. Take it down. Two, three. Other side. I think I wanted to do six each side, didn't I? One, two, three. Uneven push up. So to the floor. Walk it over. Three, four, five, six. Let's do a bridge march. Take it up. Lifting the hips, extend one leg, take it down. Lift it up, other side. All right, take it down.
2 minutes. So next we've got 8 reps of each. Again, side to side or toe tapping. Ten seconds. 3, 2, 1. 8 squat press. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Front squat. Pause. 5, 6, 7, 8. Around the world. 5, 6, 7, 8. Bicep curls. 5, 6, 7, 8. Overhead press. 5, 6, 7, 8. Lunge high knee. 4 each side. Let's get nice and low. 1, 4. Swap it over. 4. Uneven push-ups. If you can, do them on your toes. Walk it over. 7. One more. Bridge march. 8 each side. Feet on the pot. Lift it up. 1, 2, 3. Take it down. Take a water break. Toe tap it out. 2.5 minutes, 8 reps again. 3, 2, 1. Squat reach. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Around the world. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bicep curl. 4, 6, 8. Take it up over the head. 5, 6, 7, 8. Lunge high knee. See if you can touch the ground with that back knee. 1, 3, 4. Other side. Oh, can I get as low on this one? 1, 2, 3, 4. Uneven push-ups on knees or on toes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, bridge march. Let's extend that leg, drop it down, lift it up. 1, 2, 3. Take it down. Bring it up to seated. Elevate the ankles if you can. Russian twist. Two. Three. Four. Oh, almost there. All right. Tap it out. We're 10 reps next round. So 3 minute round. Choose your speed. Either tap it down at low speed. Or step it up a notch. 10 seconds. Squat press. 10 reps. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Front squat pose. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1. Around the world. One more inside. Once you've done your push-ups, bridge march. Lift it up, extend, take it down, lift, one. Dig that heel in, lift those hips nice and high. Two. Three. Four. Five. Bring it down. Grab your pot. Elevate your legs if you can. Cross those heels. Bring it all the way down to the floor. Three. If you want to make it harder, extend the arms. Four. Five. Bring it up. And time. All right. So next up, we've got burpees after the twist and down your plank for the rest of the time. Toe tap it out. 10 seconds. 10 reps again. Squat and reach. Nine, 10, front squat. Four, five, six, seven, nine, 10. Let's not rush those ones. Take it around. Keep the core really tight as you pull it around. Two, three, seven, nine, 10, take it up. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, take it down, lunge high knee. Keep that heel on the pot. One, two, nice and low. Three, four, five, other side. Three, four, five, take it down, uneven push-ups. On toes or on knees. Lift it up nice and high. Let's drop. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, oh, 10. Take it down. Russian twist, hop to floor. Elevate the feet if you can. One, three, five, seven, nine, 10. Burpees, jump it out. Jump it in, take it out. One, two, three, take it down. Side to side. We're almost there. This round we're up to 12 reps. So it's kind of consistently slowing us up. 10 seconds. Toe tap it out if you want the extra bird. Squat press in 3. 12. 11, 10, 8, 6, 4, 2, 1, drop it down and 1, 2, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, around the world. Really get a good twist in there. 7, 8, 9, get nice and low in the hips. 10, 11, 12, bring it up, bicep curls. 10, 8, 6, 4, 2, and 1. Take it up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nine, 10, 11, 12. Reverse lunge, high knee. So drop it down. 6 each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Other side. 1, 3, 4, 5, Six. All right. Uneven push up. One. Five, six, seven, eight, 10, 11, 12. Reach back. Got a minute 20 on the clock. I think we're gonna make it. Six each side. Let's lift. Dangerous on me. So when you apply that pressure, we don't want the pot to slip. Three, four, really deep. Five, six, let's swap sides. One, two, three, four, five, six, take it down, uneven push. Let's do it on toes because we can. Two. Three. If you can't do it on toes, double. Four. Five. Six. Otherwise, bring it up. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Oh, that was tough. Reach back. Feet on your pot. Let's lift it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, bring it up. Russian twist, cross those feet. Take it out wide, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, baby. Ooh, we got 40 seconds. 2. Instead of 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3. Okay, so what the exercises are. Okay, for starters, we have jump overs. So we're jumping over the pot, turning, over, turn, over, turn. So 30 seconds of that. Then we're gonna do a squat over. So 1 foot on in a squat, and we're gonna skip it over. So all the weight is in the pot as you bounce over. Keep it low, like so. Third exercise, we're dropping it down for mountain climbers. So 30 seconds of each exercise, and then we're gonna finish with one final drill. Okay, if we have time actually, we might even run out of time on that one. Okay. So starting with jump overs first. Let's get ourselves ready. 5, 3,
Jump it in. So we're here for 30 seconds. Keep it low. That's it. If you need something a little lower intensity, just step it on, step it off. But keep it low. Keep that pointer foot out to the side nice and light. Weight of the body is in the heel on the pot. All right, mountain climbers.
Ready?
Go. You'll need a bit of endurance here. Like I am too. 20 seconds, I start to build that speed. This is it. Bigger. 10 seconds. All the way to the end. 3, 2, 1. Time. Woo. Just going to catch my breath for a second. Puffy as I am, just remember it's all about getting the carbon dioxide out, not about getting that oxygen in. Your skin will actually absorb oxygen from the air. When your cardiovascular system gets stimulated and that energy process kicks in to give us the energy to fuel our workouts, there's like a byproduct like that. Well, think of it as exhaust emissions. So two things that will happen once your aerobic system starts working is, A, your body will try and dispel the byproduct through urine, hence why you always need to wee right after warm up. Doesn't matter how many times you go before the session, I still need to wee after the warm up, and that's because that's getting rid of that waste product from creating the energy. The other thing it does is expel it through the lungs via carbon dioxide. So it's a good thing to keep in mind if you're a runner or during HIIT, high-intensity interval training. You get puffed because your body's producing more carbon dioxide than oxygen that it's taking in. So think about those long, big breaths out, and then on the recoil of your lungs will take in as much oxygen as they need. When people try and breathe in too much, when they're short of breath, that's where you start to get dizzy, and you're essentially just trapping the carbon dioxide that's trying to get out by putting more oxygen in there. So big exhales, empty the lungs. The lungs will expand on their own, take the oxygen in, and you'll expand more out. So once the heart rate's come down a little, I can finally talk properly again. Let me know how you went with that. We're gonna move into a stretch. Well done if you survived it all the way to the end and gave it your all. It was a little bit tougher than I thought it was gonna be when I was planning it. But that's good. That's what we want. All right, so everyone laying down on the ground. I'm just looking for my stretch playlist. All right. So laying down. Let's take that right leg up.
Saw the world turning in my sheets, and once again I cannot sleep.
Rotate the ankle.
Look out the door and hit the street. Look at the stars beneath my feet. Remember rights that I did wrong.
Let's draw it in a little more.
So here I go. Hello, hello.
There bend to the knee.
My mind is money.
So the knee across the body. You've done a few of my sessions. You should be starting to get this off by heart now. Let's bring it back to center. Ankle on the knee, open the hip.
So I sent something to fight, and one came back at dead of night. Said he'd seen my enemy. Said he looked just like me. So I said,
squeeze it in
myself
and release. Left leg up. Rotate that ankle. Bend with the knee, take it into the chest.
For a second chance, I'm screaming at the top of my voice. Give me reason.
Take it across the body.
Don't give cause I'll just make the same.
Oh, my face is steaming. I can see
again.
It. Alright, let's roll it over. And one arm across the front.
We will meet and maybe talk and not just speak. Don't buy the promises, cause there are no promises I keep.
Take it to the front. Up and over.
If you enjoyed that workout, don't be afraid to share the group, okay? Maybe give me a little review. Say, Jasmine is absolutely kicking my ass. This is rad. And let's try and, you know, build it a little. Let's get right into it. I will be running face-to-face group fitness as well when all of this lockdown and everything is over. So if you live locally, especially give me a shout out, because this will be the first time I've run boot camp up here, so I need all the help I can get. And if you're doing this later, you didn't catch it live, you caught it later, make sure you comment below so that I know that you've done the workout. Again, this is going to prevent me from hustling you to see where you're at with your training and hammering you going, I haven't seen you in any classes this week. This is pretty much how I rate your attendance and keep track, okay? If anybody's interested in their fitness testing and health assessment this Sunday, drop a comment and let me know and I'll book you in. Basically what happens with that is this is something, like a shorter version of what I would run through with a new PT client, and I used to offer it to a lot of my bootcamp members as well, where basically we go through a few, like just four fitness drills just to assess your upper and lower body strength and endurance. We go through your weight. So we take your, well, you take your weight and I log it because we'll be doing it via Zoom. So weighing in, I'll show you how to take your own measurements. We track all that down, and then I can evaluate your macro and calorie needs if you want to do calorie counting. So you've got a general idea of what you need, how much of what. But we have a big chat about that in the consultation anyway. We also do a bit of goal setting as well. So I can help you out with what your goals are, recommend, you know, what you, how to get you there, basically. So we go through all of that and then record it all down and everything. And then the best thing about it is, especially doing it if you're just starting exercise, like an exercise regime now, it means next time, next month when we do it again, you'll kick your own ass, okay? So your results will be heaps better. Your centimeters lost will be heaps bigger and everything. So don't be ashamed or think, oh, I might just give it until next month and get a bit fitter first. The unfitter you are, the better your results are next month, okay? So don't be shy to book in. And yeah, we'll get you all up and running and going hard. So also in May, we're going to be running a simultaneous program within this group. It looks like 8-Minute Abs is in the running at the moment. So I usually run a lot of online 30-day challenges and everything. So I thought it'd be good to run one within the group just to add that little bit of extra, push and motivation for the month. So if you go to topics and click have your say, you'll see that there's a poll in there, or if you flick through the feed, find the poll for which program you'd like added to JB Go. There's everything from a run walk challenge to a 30-day workout body weight challenge. The Bootylicious Bikini Body Program, which is all with the booty bands. 8-minute abs or 30 days to splits, I think, which is all working on that leg flexibility and lower body flexibility. So let me know what you'd rather, and then we'll kick that off next Friday. So well done to everyone that made it for the third day in a row to Sunrise class. Don't forget to post your selfies in the appropriate post. And we've got Go Your Way 30-minute barbell training coming up at 9 a.m. So if you feel like you want a bit of strength training, join me for that. If you don't have a barbell, you can just do it with a dumbbell or two dumbbells. Okay, so just make sure your dumbbells are a little bit, if you can, if you've got interchangeable ones, make them a little bit heavier than usual. But if not, just use whatever dumbbells you've got. And it's just a 30-minute session, just going through those basic, those traditional sort of gym moves, okay? So that's it for me now. I'm off to have a coffee. If I don't see you again today, have a great day. And don't forget to also vote for the nutritional seminar, the nutrition and health seminar, tomorrow night at 5 p.m. All right, peace out, crew. I'll catch you later on. Bye.